G'day.
Hello there.
I'm Ozzy Robbo.
I'm English Gent.
And welcome to our visit to the Brown Derby, our return visit to the Brown Derby.
Yeah, so our first ever series from Walt Disney World, well, first ever series, was Walt Disney World back in 2009, where we started doing more dining. And one of those dining areas and expertise is the Brown Derby in Hollywood Studios. And we thought, last minute, let's rebook it. Let's try it again, but try the lunch and see if we can get a different type of service. So you're going to be interested to see maybe how it differs, whether there's any additions or exits from the menu. So please come join us as we rejoin the Brown Derby for its delectation.
What?
No idea. So last time we were sat right in the middle of the room, which wasn't the best, but our server has taken us over to one of the little booths, which is actually really lovely and comfy. This can seat up to four people, but there's only two of us, so we've got plenty of space. As usual, they basically explained that you've got the QR code, if you want to scan that right now to see the menu. We usually use the app because it's easier, and we've had some complications with the actual scan code with our network. And then they also give a full drinks list, which is two-sided. So you've got plenty of choice. We haven't actually even had a look at the menu. We've booked it so late that we haven't even sort of had time to peruse it. So I'm really looking forward to seeing what's on offer for lunch. I think it's an all-day lunch, though, so fingers crossed. Air conditioning is fully on, which is very much appreciated. Thank you very much, Disney, for paying the bill on the air conditioning in this place. I love it. Actually, this is a really nice spot.
So much better than what we were before in the centre of the room.
Yeah, we were under the arch over there before, and I had my back permanently to the rest of the room, which I don't really enjoy. You don't get to get the atmosphere and the vibe and all the Imagineers have put into it. So I don't eat watermelon very often as, you know, a fruit and vegetable. For me, this is quite refreshing, so it might actually encourage me to eat more watermelon. It's basically Sprite. With watermelon, and it's really, really, really refreshing. And it's pink.
It's basically just kind of a Sprite with berry kind of flavouring in there. Malibu Beach, I believe it was called.
The scallops are so tender and just melt in your mouth. But everything else complements it, the sauce and everything just gives it a little bit of a extra zest. Beautiful.
Prawn cocktail is very different from the one we're used to in, I guess, Europe or England, or so I wasn't quite expecting it in this format, where the prawns are all separate on top and then there's a sauce underneath. The sauce has got quite a tang. I can't tell if it's got a bit of a kick. I don't think it does, but I think it's just the tangy nature of it. But it's really, really tangy sauce. And then ribbons of cucumber on the side. Very nice.
Diplomat, and I don't think I should be allowed to be on a jury because I can read minds.
Yeah, really nice burger. Chili jam's got a really nice flavour, and the egg on top finishes up very nicely.
The mushrooms, there's different mushrooms in there. Each one has its own little flavour. None of them are too strong. The risotto is so creamy. The leaf dressing on top is a really nice compliment. And then there's sweet potato with a sauce around the side, and it's like a sweet sauce. So you've got like a vinaigrette with a sweet sauce, and then the textures of the mushrooms, which are so well done. Beautiful, really beautiful. So now we're going to try, it's one of the extras. This is the crab and orzo gratin. So I have no idea what to expect from this. Ooh. That is really nice. Very hot. As in heat, not as in flavour. The gratin is kind of quite strong. The crab isn't dry. Sometimes when I've had crab dishes, if it's crab meat, it tends to sort of overtake the dish and become rather dry. This is beautiful. We've gone to share a dessert, which is the 50th celebration Baked Alaska. This is layers of strawberry basil sorbet, vanilla gelato, and sponge cake coated in toasted meringue and caramelized brownie bites.
So, we just got out of the Brown Derby. How was lunch, Darren?
Refreshingly lovely. Service was amazing. The atmosphere is great. The food was really good. Service was beyond good for me. I was really happy. So what do we both have? So we started with the, I had the scallops. Really tasty, really well done. So sort of tender and succulent and moist. I would give those 5 Kenobis.
Wow.
5 Kenobis, yeah.
I had the shrimp cocktail, prawn cocktail, prawns. And it was very enjoyable. Nice little tangy sauce to go with it. I would give it 4 shrimps and a barbie.
Yeah, yeah, that's respectable.
And then for the main, you had the...
I had the mushroom risotto, which has sweet potato in it and like a puree. And kind of like a vinaigrette, but also like a sweet caramelized onion flavor to it as well. That was beautiful. That was like probably the best mushroom risotto I've ever had. I've had a few different risottos, but mushroom risotto generally I tend to sort of steer away from, but that was so nice. I am going to give that 4.5 Kenobis.
Wow. And I had the burger. It was a very nice, well-cooked burger. Yeah, very well done. The egg was nice on top. A nice little bacon jam. The bacon flavor wasn't, too strong, but no, very, very nice overall meal. So I'd give it 4.5 shrimps on a barbie.
And then just as an extra, you can have extras with your meal, so with your main sort of dish. I decided to try the crab and orzo gratin. Really nice. However, it is an extra, but I would share it. Definitely share it. Maybe even 3 people could share that, because it's very, very rich.
Very rich.
Really lovely for the first few bites, but then it gets quite...
Stays warm for a long time as well.
Yeah, it comes out scalding hot in a sort of a skillet thing. Yeah, beautiful, but really, really heavy. I'm going to give it 3.5 Kenobis, because it's nice, but it's way too rich and my taste.
And then you ordered dessert.
I ordered both desserts. So as usual, Rob wasn't really partial to dessert, but then when we ordered it, it was like, oh, let's share it.
I had a little bit of it.
It was the 50th anniversary Baked Alaska, and it was lovely. It was really, really nice. Again, one I couldn't eat on my own. Really beautifully presented. Flavors, so many flavors. So you've got like a really sweet, sugary, brownie sort of cubes. And then you've got the classic Baked Alaska, but the sorbets inside were beautiful. And so was the meringue, I would say, as well.
Yeah. So really, what's your...
I would give that 4 Kenobis.
I'd give it 4 as well. It's a massive combination of very sweet flavours, so there's a lot going on in that dish.
That's worth trying. Yeah. Yeah, definitely worth trying and sharing.
And overall, what do you think of your experience at the Brown Derby this time compared to last time?
I would give it... I would give the actual overall experience 4 Kenobis.
So I'd give it 4.5 shrimps and a barbie.
I was near there.
Because... the service was so much better this time. I mean, it does help that we were on the edge as opposed to in the middle,
yeah,
on one of the tables. So that definitely helped with the atmosphere. But also our waitress was a lot
superb.
Better than the guy we had last time.
Absolutely superb and really pleasant and really helpful. And just made it really easy to find what you wanted on the menu. So yeah, couldn't fault
always
it.
Always smiling, always very happy.
You know what, I'm going to give it 4.5. Yeah, I'm going to give it 4.5.
Wow.
That's extra 0.5 Kenobi matters.
Okay. So Darren, we just got off Mickey's Runaway Train again. How was it for you?
It was really fun. We're at the back this time rather than front, and it takes us a different route. You kind of come into the story later, so you can catch a few more details. It's beautiful. It's just so beautifully done. However, when we got to my favourite room, Daisy had broke down.
She wasn't moving her mouth. I don't know if I can't remember if she talked the first time or not, but she was not doing anything at all. She was not. Yeah. And then the announcement came over the top that the.
Attention. Attention riders, we have temporarily stopped Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway. Please remain seated.
Say, Bowser, Miles Button, you have to remain seated.
Broken.
No, Mickey, I'm just a voice.
Yeah,
was she was like a statue, but her eyes were still going, like looking at us all, like as if she was judging us. It's like looking into our deepest, darkest thoughts and souls.
No, Mickey. Attention, train passengers. Please remain seated. Your runaway railway will now resume.
1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Oh, excellent. Let's
go. But it added like a little bit of flavour because everyone just literally sat. We sat there for quite a while.
We did,
and they kept bringing the talk over the voiceover changes to kind of add a little bit of comedy into when it breaks down. So you have Mickey having a back and forth with the announcer, and I quite like, that's a lovely little detail. But yeah, I love that ride. I think it's really sweet.
Yeah,
it's you can't.
And then it got back on track. Fun. We didn't get it scored off. We got back on track, and then we went back on again, and just keep going.
So now, I think we've done enough of earthly things. I think we need to head off planet. I need to get some droid parts.
So, something that could be seen as a strange occurrence for us, we've been here since 10 this morning, and we've only just made it to Batuu at 5 o'clock in the evening.
Yeah.
So, quite late for us. Not hitting the Star Wars park.
That also says something about the lack of availability for anything in Batuu for the whole day. So, Rise of Resistance has been down until about an hour ago, pretty much all day, so we've just waited and waited and waited, and we thought we want to get something in before we leave.
So, Darth Darren, what have you got in your hands?
I have got a thermal detonator.
Run!
So we've all the times we've been here, we've never ever bought one of these, and we finally thought maybe we should. $6 each, so they're not cheap. I think they hold deceptively quite a bit of code.
Supposedly it looks like 330, isn't it? 330 mils?
Yeah, I think it's
330 mils?
399.
Okay, so it's
13.5 fluid ounce.
Yeah, really.
It looks smaller, but it actually seems to hold more. But yeah, it's basically styled after a thermal detonator. And it's done in the language that is Star Wars. I can't remember what it is off the top of my head. It's Arabesh. So there's Sprite, Diet, I think it's either Diet Coke or Zero, and then regular Coca-Cola. We actually really like the Coca-Cola right here because it's got like sort of sugary, more taste. But yeah, so we're finally going to have one. And oh, it's gone off. It's gone off in my face. Disaster. Wow. It's just like the cantina in Book of Fett. Amazingly, it's taste of Coke.
It's like exactly the same.
It's actually quite easy to drink out of this. It's actually probably easier to drink out of this than it is out of an old bottle.
What?
The dropship with the droid, the thing you get escaping from Rise of Resistance with the black droid.
Ah.
Has a car that comes out and the sound effects and light effects. Yeah. Very nice. But
$75.
Yeah. It's quite heavy, big. It's taking hundreds of photos. It's that really nice time of the evening.
Profitable expeditions.
Chewbacca, my fine furry friend!
Yes, as we agreed, you let us use the ship.
So Darren, how was your experience on Smuggler's Run?
Well, it was quite a refreshing take on it. We were given, so this is what, our fourth go on it?
Third or fourth, yeah.
And we've been given pilots every single time. And we actually, the last time, we didn't want to be pilots.
This time we were given pilots, and we gladly donated them to somebody who'd never done it before. So they were really happy. We were really happy because we were gunners. So that was great to start off with. But the biggest shock for us was the kind of bonus round, the kind of level where... So normally after you've done the run, the smuggler run, you kind of go back to the planet of Batu, and you sometimes go through meteorites, but there's nothing, you know, apart from just flying through and then landing. This time we went through meteorites and it was basically a full-on space battle with TIE fighters for a good couple of minutes or so. So that was a really happy bonus, but we kept kind of looking, glancing at each other like as if to say, is this right? And then when we landed, they Hondo basically mentioned about possible stowaway or you know, an extra thing that's attached itself, which I'm assuming he meant Minox, but yeah, it was like, it was very strange.
Yeah, so we were kind of sick of doing the pilots thing, so we kind of glad to gave that up actually. And we were gunners, but I still think it would have been more interesting to do the engineers because they get more buttons to press and a variety of more buttons to press. But it was a good run. It was a very bumpy ride because they didn't know how to pilot and they were going all over the place and smashing into everything. But it was entertaining to sit back and watch and not be in the pilot seat and kind of watch it back from a little further away and just watch the whole thing. And then, as you say, the asteroid sequence with the TIE fighters was quite a surprise. That was a nice surprise because it just kept on going. And it felt a bit strange because we've done it quite a few times before and we've never had that before. But it was in a good way because we got to play the game for a bit longer. And then weirdly we were sat at the end of the game while he was giving that speech about an extra creature or something that was attached to the ship or something.
And then we were being moved around, you could feel the ship being moved.
So even though it was a pretty awful game and a pretty awful ride, it was actually quite entertaining because we got to see elements we hadn't seen before.
Never seen.
Yeah.
It's the Jedi gear set, so you've got like the binoculars, but that's the holo.
Right.
The thing you put.
Yeah.
$29.99 and a comlink. Quite like that. I like it for that.
Who's on the...
So you've got Cody.
It's really Cody. They're not very good characters, aren't they?
What, Yoda, Cody, Maul.
Sidious.
No, not Sidious.
Grievous. I think they look really cool. Do I get one? No. That is heavy material.
What is that, the Emperor's? Or?
Yeah. Tell by that.
How much is that?
It's got the robe underneath, look. Not sure. Where does one find a price on an Emperor's robe? Where is it?
It's cool, they've got like a headpiece over there as well.
Oops. Yeah, it's Amidala's, isn't it?
That's actually really cheap, what I thought it would be.
Yeah, the Ash and Brine have got it.
I also really like that.
I quite like those.
Yeah. They're both done kind of... I actually quite like the way it's done here, of course.
I feel like there's less stuff in here than there used to be last time.
So holocrons, you've got...
Did you get one of those last time?
No, I was going to, and no, I didn't get around to it. So holocrons, you can buy the Sith one. So you get a Sith crystal. Well, actually, no, all they've got is a Jedi one.
But what if you get a Sith crystal?
I don't know.
Pretty cool.
It's actually quite light.
You know what this is? It's a Pandora's box. It's going to open up hell. Yeah. We've got such pleasures to show you, Sarah.
Doesn't the crystal go in there?
Yeah, you put it in one part. I don't know how you get into it, but... Is it that? No. That? I think it might be somewhere here or something. Never used ones, I don't know. Apparently the Sith ones are very popular and you can't get them imported onto planet now. There's still no Doc Ondo.
So this is the packaging, the chip, the droid personality chips used to come in with this. Now we're doing it in a handy little cassette. Well, no, but it does make it easier to sort of like store it and not lose it, because they are easily lost.
How much is a cassette?
Same price, just different. $14.99, but instead of cardboard you get, when you look at it, you don't really get much for your money, because it's like, I think it's
$75. Whoa. Is this the Hasbro?
Yeah. Black Series, special edition. I used to own the original droid factory. Sorry, droid factory.
He, does he say gonk? He's got a battery in him. Battery. From the droid factory. How's he? He must talk. Oh, there you go.
No. I really like that C-3PO. I've never been able to make these things, but that is really cool.
So one of the nifty things we like on Genie Plus, one of the good things, is their magic lenses. So we've got this one here, where you can basically put on fireworks in the sky. So go across, turn it to night time, and then wherever you press your finger, you get fireworks, and it takes into account the objects that are in front of it.
I think the strawberry and the banana started like 2 weeks ago or so, didn't it? So I'm hoping to try. I never really have a desire to eat popcorn, but...
I tend to be one.
But when I found out they've got strawberry and banana, I was actually like, I want to try some of them.
And we might as well, because we're not going on Rise of Resistance now.
Not that you're salty.
Not that I'm salty or anything. Aha! Yeah, Lightning Lane is about 45 minutes or more long, so we're not doing that.
So, a little update on the popcorn. They don't sell the banana and strawberry in Batuu East.
Ooh.
They only sell the strawberry and banana in Batuu West. I didn't realise that. I just thought it was company-wide. I thought it was like both. I don't know why they're just doing it in one section and not the other.
There's the same thing with certain drinks as well.
But I'd heard about this through watching Ordinary Adventures, so I was really excited about trying banana and strawberry-flavoured popcorn. So this is apparently berry with a lime chili thing.
Here we have the blueberry lemon pound cake mixed with the sweet chili lime. Tastes a little bit like Fruit Loops, it's pretty good.
Tastes like what?
A little bit like Fruit Loops.
I wonder if that's what you've got. Ooh. Basically, what did she say? It tastes like Fruit Loops?
She said it tastes like Fruit Loops. I mean, I'm not the biggest fan of popcorn anyway. It's quite a mild flavour.
Yeah, I can see. I'm doing like a mix thing. A bit of everything. Yeah, I'm getting Fruit Loops.
Are you?
Not just me. Fruit Loop.
So you're quite a connoisseur of popcorn. And you are, you do, or used to eat a lot of popcorn when I first met you, especially. So what's your evaluation on the popcorn?
I'll try a bit more. Now I've got Fruit Loops in my head, I can't get it out of my head. It feels like I'm eating stale Fruit Loops. Like as in popcorn you've left, cereal you've left out a little bit too long. But then, I'm the kind of person who has a lot of butter on my salted popcorn. Or I go complete the other way and have like very sweet popcorn. This is very savoury with a berry-y, kind of like a fruity aftertaste. It's alright. I give it 3 Kenobis.
I mean, I'm not getting a lot of flavour. The purple ones seem to have more flavour than the other, the red ones.
Yeah.
But still, I'm not getting a huge amount. I'll give the popcorn maybe 3, being generous, 3 shrimps on a barbie.
Yeah, generous 3.
But very disappointed that Batuu East does not sell banana and strawberry flavoured popcorn.
Boo.
I mean, I literally haven't had popcorn in about 5 years because I find it so boring, such a boring meal. But I wanted to try this one because I thought they had it. Just like old times, me delivering pizzas to tables. So we are in Blaze Pizza for the second time on this trip.
Where is Blaze Pizza?
Blaze Pizza is in Disney Springs. It's by the water, by Zara. I don't know how else to describe the location, but it's a very good pizza. We've had it many times, dating back to 2017 when we were first brought here by our friends Ted and Mish, who you will have seen on some of the earlier episodes of this trip.
How much do you pay for a pizza?
So I believe the price is $10.95. for a make your own pizza, so that's what we've done. So I've chosen pepperoni, olives, applewood bacon, and chopped garlic. Applewood bacon.
Wow. I just went for I have pepperoni, but I went for a mixture of cheeses, baby cheeses.
I also got gorgonzola cheese in mine as well.
I was going to go for that, but I thought I might overpower it, so I put some red onions.
And then a strange cup with
it's like a, one
no
of
straws,
the,
but it's like
almost like a cold brew cup. So what are we here for in Disney Springs? Are we here for a little bit of entertainment, a little bit of fun?
I don't know, you're going to sing and dance, so what entertainment are we here for?
The part over there. No, so we're going to have a look around. We need a new suitcase to take back all our junk. So we're going to look for a new suitcase, I think. Maybe a few pin swappings, or at least some new pins. And maybe some Gerard Maruyama merch.
There is a shirt I want to try and find.
Yeah. The hunt goes on for the Trader Sam shirt.
Trader Sam shirt that's sold out everywhere. Hopefully they might have got some back in today.
Not the one I got from the previous episode, but yeah, a different one. So fingers crossed, let's see what's happening. Here he comes, Mr. Pizza Man. Right, shall we go and have a look to see if there is any virtual queue for Gideon's? I doubt there is, but you never know.
So what did you think of Blaze?
Always good. It really is down, when you're building your own though, it's always down to your own choices. I think I chose the wrong cheese on that one, for me it's always, I'd say 4 Kenobis.
I'm going to go 4.5 shrimps and barbie because I love Blaze, and the quality was always outstanding as always. You know, not absolutely perfect, but it's a really good solid 4.5 out of 5 shrimps and a barbie.
So at Disney Springs there's a new store for us, which we've never seen there before, but there is apparently one in Disney in California, and that's called Love Pop, and essentially it's laser cooked pop-up greetings cards. We really, really wanted to buy some, however the sales assistants were a little bit full on with the hard sell and it put us off. But there are some really lovely designs. So there's obviously Star Wars, there's loads and loads of Disney. Next time we go, I think I will probably brave it and get something. What are you in line for, Rob?
Dole Whip.
Dole Whip?
Pineapple Dole Whip. Pineapple Dole Whip pineapple float, apparently. I'm not sure what's floating, but we'll soon find out in a minute.
Dole Whip's floating. Might be my first one ever. So, Rob, what makes a pineapple Dole Whip so special to you?
That it's pineapple and it's made by Dole. I know it's got that famous name. I had one a couple of years ago when we first got to Florida. I remember enjoying it, but I don't really remember much about it. So we're going to try, I don't even know if it was pineapple at the time. It might have been a different flavor, I'm not sure.
I've got a feeling it was like a swirl.
I got a feeling it was like an orange or something, maybe.
An orange.
But anyway, we've got a pineapple Dole Whip as opposed to a pineapple float Dole Whip, which we thought we were getting before. The float is with pineapple juice. Darren doesn't like pineapple juice, he's quite fussy, so we've just gone for the pineapple float, pineapple Dole Whip.
I'd like to try some scallops.
We're going for the pineapple Dole Whip.
Whip?
Whip.
Whip.
Ooh, let me have some of that cool whip. What'd you say?
Whip.
Whip.
Cool whip.
Cool whip, yeah.
You mean cool whip?
Yeah, cool whip.
It's quite a spoonful. Oh, he got it all the way. No. Oh.
It's very soft. It's very cold. It's very pineapple-y. Pineapple-y?
Pineapple-y. The Italian pineapple.
Very, very nice.
Very nice. I've got a feeling I'm not going to like it. Oh.
That's
So Darren, how was your first experience of tasting the pineapple gold whip?
Whip? It's actually very nice.
Wow. The wonders never cease.
I'd actually like to try one of the other mixes, the flavours. I wouldn't still want it in a float, like with the juice. But as a soft serve, yeah, awesome. Now I feel warranted in all the Orange Bird merch I buy.
I didn't send the whole Orange Bird connection there because it's an orange as opposed to a pineapple.
I
oranges are associated with Florida.
I have read it, but I can't remember what it said about his attachment. But I will look into it and put some information here.
Pineapple Dole Whip is a success with you?
Yeah. To a point where I'm now wishing we had done this sooner in the vacation, because
I've been trying.
Well, it was trying. Well, no, we have. Every time we've gone up to Sunshine Terrace in Magic Kingdom, it's been packed and really long queues.
But it was only because I was desperate to have one that we actually found that they actually. So the Dole Whips are sold at Disney Springs. There is a little marketplace store
between the Shiradeli and the Marketplace Co-op.
Yes.
And just up from the pin trading. So yeah, for me,
where the train station is.
For me, it's a 5 Kenobi.
Wow.
Oh no, that's what, have you seen me just eat? I've just taken 4 spoonfuls.
Well yes, it's also a 5 out of 5 shrimps on a barbie for me with the pineapple dole whip.
We're coming up in a future episode, we're going to be in the Magic Kingdom on Valentine's Day. On Valentine's Day, they've got a special one which is kind of sprayed red with strawberries coming out of it. I'd be interested to try that, just see what that difference is. To be honest, I might try 3 other different types of Dole Whip.
G'day.
Sorry, I wasn't ready. I was pulling faces. Also, this might give you a hint. Droids, we're looking for a good time. Droids.
You need help.
Cool Whip. You're saying it weird. Why are you putting so much emphasis on the H?
What are you talking about? I'm just saying it. Cool Whip.